After Rachel had borne Joseph, Jacob said to Laban, "Give me leave to go back to my own homeland. Give me my wives and my children for whom I have served you, that I may go, for well you know what services I have rendered you." But Laban said to him, "If you will indulge me, I have learned by divination that the Lord has blessed me on your account." And he continued, "Name the wages due from me, and I will pay you." But he said, "You know well how I have served you, and how your livestock has fared with me. For the little you had before I came has grown to much, since the Lord has blessed you wherever I turned. And now, when shall I make provision for my own household?" He said, "What shall I pay you?" And Jacob said, "Pay me nothing. If you will do this thing for me, I will again pasture and keep your flocks. Let me pass through your whole flock today, removing from there every speckled and spotted animal, every dark-coloured sheep, and every spotted and speckled goat. Such shall be my wages. In the future, when you go over my wages, let my honesty toward you testify for me. If there are among my goats any that are not speckled or spotted, or any sheep that are not dark-coloured, they got there by theft." And Laban said, "Very well, let it be as you say." But that same day he removed the streaked and spotted he-goats, and all the speckled and spotted she-goats, every one that had white on it, and all the dark-coloured sheep, and left them in the charge of his sons. And he put a distance of 3 days' journey between himself and Jacob, while Jacob was pasturing the rest of Laban's flock. Jacob then got fresh shoots of poplar and of almond and plane, and peeled white stripes in them, laying bare the white of the shoots. The rods that he had peeled he set up in front of the goats, in the troughs, the water receptacles that the goats came to drink from. Their mating occurred when they came to drink, and since the goats mated by the rods, the goats brought forth streaked, speckled, and spotted young. But Jacob dealt separately with the sheep. He made these animals face the streaked or wholly dark-coloured animals in Laban's flock. And so he produced special flocks for himself, which he did not put with Laban's flocks. Moreover, when the sturdier animals were mating, Jacob would place the rods in the troughs in full view of the animals, so that they mated by the rods. But with the feebler animals he would not place them there. Thus the feeble ones went to Laban and the sturdy to Jacob. So the man grew exceedingly prosperous and came to own large flocks, maidservants and menservants, camels and asses. Now he heard the things that Laban's sons were saying, "Jacob has taken all that was our father's, and from that which was our father's he has built up all this wealth." Jacob also saw that Laban's manner toward him was not as it had been in the past. Then the Lord said to Jacob, "Return to the land of your fathers, where you were born, and I will be with you." Jacob and Rachel and Leah called to the field where his flock was and said to them, "I see that your father's manner toward me is not as it has been in the past, but the God of my father has been with me. As you know, I have served your father with all my might, but your father has cheated me, changing my wages time and again. God, however, would not let him do me harm. If he said thus, 'The speckled shall be your wages,' then all the flocks would drop speckled young. And if he said thus, 'The streaked shall be your wages,' then all the flocks would drop streaked young. God has taken away your father's livestock and given it to me." Once at the mating time of the flocks, I had a dream in which I saw that the he-goats mating with the flock were streaked, speckled, and mottled. And in the dream, an angel of God said to me, "Jacob." Here I answered, and he said, "Note well that all the he-goats which are mating with the flock are streaked, speckled, and mottled, for I have noted all that Laban has been doing to you. I am the God of Bethel, where you anointed a pillar and where you made a vow to me. Now arise and leave this land and return to your native land." Then Rachel and Leah answered him, saying, "Have we still a share in the inheritance of our father's house? Surely he regards us as outsiders now that he has sold us and has used up our purchase price. Truly, all the wealth that God has taken away from our father belongs to us and to our children. Now then, do just as God has told you." Thereupon Jacob put his children and wives on camels, and he drove off all his livestock and all the wealth that he had amassed, the livestock in his possession that he had acquired in Padan Aram, to go to his father Isaac in the land of Canaan. Meanwhile, Laban had gone to shear his sheep, and Rachel stole her father's household idols. Jacob kept Laban, the Aramean, in the dark, not telling him that he was fleeing, and fled with all that he had. Soon he was across the Euphrates and heading toward the hill country of Gilead. On the third day, Laban was told that Jacob had fled. So he took his kinsmen with him and pursued him a distance of 7 days, catching up with him in the hill country of Gilead. But God appeared to Laban, the Aramean, in a dream by night and said to him, "Beware of attempting anything with Jacob, good or bad." Laban overtook Jacob. Jacob had pitched his tent on the height, and Laban with his kinsmen encamped in the hill country of Gilead. And Laban said to Jacob, "What did you mean by keeping me in the dark and carrying off my daughters like captives of the sword? Why did you flee in secrecy and mislead me and not tell me? I would have sent you off with festive music, with timbrel and lyre. You did not even let me kiss my sons and daughters goodbye. It was a foolish thing for you to do. I have it in my power to do you harm. But the God of your father said to me last night, 'Beware of attempting anything with Jacob, good or bad.' Very well, you had to leave because you were longing for your father's house. But why did you steal my gods?"